today after doing the frame notch over here. We're gonna just get, I can't do the whole tube front end yet, but I wanna just get the front bar in and then get started on the back. The rain's finally clearing up for the day over here. I hope it holds out. So we'll get a little bit of the front end cut and then get the tubes bent. The tube, the one main tube that goes, or what I call the main tube that goes across the front bent, measured out, all that good stuff, and welded in. And there's another hurricane coming. This one looks like, hopefully it's gonna be a lot less and not quite hit us. So I have to take everything back down because that's just gonna really throw a damper on things. So here we go. I'm cutting in the center line here on both of these. I measured both sides as close as I can get it, which is probably plenty close. And we're gonna get that cut right there. Cut the front frame horn off and then bend our tube. I already did a measurement from here over to the end. We're about an average between the two sides of 28 inches. Don't forget these move. So we're gonna get it as far forward, I was told to do it, as I can. So here we go. Of course, that's my last cutting wheel, so we'll finish up with a little sawzall. And that battery's dead, isn't it? Son of a bitch. Yeah, it's got a little bit left in it. All right, so the two front horns are off. Now we're gonna make templates. Trace these out, weld 1/8 inch plate on there, and then we'll measure out and get an exact dimension of what we want our tube, and then go from there. Okay, real quick, I wanna go over one thing here. Don't forget, on this car, I'm running a motor plate and a rack and pinion. So obviously in cutting the front horn off here, that's where your steering box mounts to. So if you're going with a traditional setup, you know, not a rack, you're doing a traditional steering box with inner and outer tie rods and a drag link and your center link and your idler arm and so on and so forth, you're not going to be able to do that. This is, you know, somebody actually commented, and I was appreciative that he did, on my last video with the notch. You know, why do it so drastically? Me, I like to clear it up, make a lot of room, especially when you're doing, I don't know exactly what drivetrain this is going to get at the end of the day. I'd rather have the room and have it all done now instead of trying to do it twice, because once this car goes together, I want to hopefully keep it together. And you know, I'm sure there'll be a lot of engine and gear changes as a step up combinations and all that, but just to get it together for now, at least all this is done while the body's off. It's a lot easier, so that's the reason behind doing this. See, with the notch, you know, obviously you got to be very careful of how close you're cutting with your control arms. I actually had pictures sent to me and my friend who did it, who I've mentioned before. This is another one of his designs that he does in the front of these, which I like. It's nice and neat, leaves you a lot of room. And once we build, we'll tube this around, then we'll build our mounts for the fenders and to hold up the front header panel and bumpers and so on and so forth off that. So here we go. I'm just going to pick a point that's the same on both of these, take a measurement, which is going to be right here. We got about 2 5/8 on there, give or take a 16th. And then on this side, right at 2 5/8 also, so we're about even. We're just going to square them off. I'm also going to just double check and make sure the frame is level in both directions, so I know when I put the bar on the front, we could just follow exactly what the frame's doing and make it nice and straight. So now we'll cut templates. This is very, very, very okay. So that one's nice and square. We'll do the same thing to the other side, and then we'll cut out these templates. did a quick little bullshit strap down because the car is heavy as hell. So hopefully I don't have to take this thing down for tomorrow. Or actually, I'm not taking it down for tomorrow. So shipped all straight to your. Too much out here for this.
Hey.
Yo, what's up? What's going on?
Do you remember if you had any lids with these?
I think a couple did. I'm not really worried about it.
Okay, then
deal.
I think that these should be the two.
So we got this tube all bent, nice and 90 and straight. Now we're just gonna cut it back to the 28 inch mark, which is what I want it to be from the plate up to the front bumper. So just on the inside of that line. And then it's gonna definitely be time to do some cleanup. Pushing a little of the outside as I can and up. So it's going to be somewhere about there. All right. So that's going to be it for me today. We're going to have to get ready for the storm. Looks like it's just starting to rain now and the wind's starting to pick up pretty good. So that's going to be it for today. Hopefully we get away with little to no damage. I'm not taking this whole ghetto garage, as I call it, down, because it's just a lot of work and it's not supposed to be too bad here. So hopefully we get away all right, and I'll see you guys hopefully tomorrow. Take care. Every time I do this, the wind is just cranking as soon as I start. So quick little announcement, I'm gonna be moving. So I'm actually moving into a place about 2 hours north of where I'm at now. It has a 2.5 car garage, so it's getting really difficult with the welding here. There's always a breeze blowing through here no matter how I try and block it, so it's tough. And I definitely need more room. I'll have an actual inside house, so it's inside garage, so it's exciting. I'll be able to get set back up and get the rest of my equipment that's still not here in there and get going. So it's gonna be a couple weeks, but I'm gonna cut this video short. I'm not going to put, hang on, I'll take this off of here. I'm not going to put the front tube on. It's all welded. It's all welded up, and I'm not going to put the front tube on because it's going to be shorter to move, which I'm trying to do the move in as little trips as possible. So I'm going to leave it as is right now, just slap some paint on this so it doesn't rust, and then we're going to pick back up as soon as I get set up. I'll probably throw a video up of the new place. Got to move some stuff around in the garage of where I'm going, because there's just the way it's set up is not right for me anyway. So that's that, but I will check you guys out definitely very soon. So thanks to all you guys that subscribe and comment and like and, you know, support what I'm doing. It's much appreciated, and it should get a lot better now that we're actually going to have a little bit better. It'll still be a driveway garage build, but just not actually physically in the driveway, I hope. So we'll see how that goes. I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.